Oh, it's not minimum. It is far from minimum! Max Domi is a leaf!
I'm Steve Dangle, welcome to my YouTube channel, and here's my in-depth analysis. Did you know he's the son of Ty?
Yeah, I Googled it. It was like a few pages down, but I Googled it.
Wow. Big night for the Leafs. Let's talk about it, but first, think you know which way it's gonna go?
I didn't, heading into tonight.
But if you do, you should make your next bet with Sports Interaction. They got all major sports on there, so it doesn't need to be the first game of the regular season. It could be the first pitch of your favorite baseball game, baby! Whatever you want, before the game, the best live in-play, prop bets. Want to bet? Head to sportsinteraction.com/SDPN and download the Sports Interaction app. But only if you're 19 plus. Please play responsibly.
Well, well, well. Can I just shout out reporter Chris, CJ, Chris Johnston, having himself a time? Because the Leafs, they go out and they get Tyler Bertuzzi. I already talked about that. That's in the previous video on this channel. Go and watch it!
1 year, $5.5 million. And we all say, oh, well, they were rumored to be in on Max Domi. That must be done.
Just to remind you what he said, yes, I know this was in the last video, but it's worth repeating.
DJ goes, even after signing Tyler Bertuzzi, the Leafs are still poking around the free agent market to see what else they can do. I don't believe the door is fully closed on Max Domi at this point.
But wait, it gets better.
Then CJ actually breaks the thing. Max Domi is joining the Leafs on a 1 year deal worth $3 million.
But wait, it gets even better.
Dave Pagnotta, Domi is currently asleep overseas, so he won't be able to sign his 1 year contract until he's awake.
And then CJ interrupts, he's in Europe, yes, but he's already signed the contract. 1 year deal at $3 million. Him! He's him!
CJ, we are not worthy, CJ. But all that to say, Max Domi is a Leaf, and this has been a long time coming, dude. Like, yeah, go have your little NHL career. Go play in Arizona. Go play in Montreal for a little bit and yell at Kapanen. We were yelling at him, too. And then go to a few other teams. He's been around.
Chicago, oof. Dallas, ooh, he was pretty good in the playoffs.
But we all knew at some point in Max Domi's career, he was going to come home. As NHL History Girl posted, just such a vital follow, here's a photo of Tie Domi with his tiny son Max during a Leafs pregame.
And this is just for me. Do you recognize the young man right above Max there? That's Alan McCauley. I recently saw him at the draft and I was like, 2002, those were some of my formative years and I just wanted to say you're a legend. And he didn't say anything, but he gave me the face like, I know I'm Alan McCauley, I'm pretty sick.
Thumbs up, I marked out. Anyway, it's 1 year, there is no risk there, none. There's probably gonna be a bunch of these signings. I mean, the Leafs were able to take advantage of two with Tyler Bertuzzi and Max Domi. The cap's gonna go up. They keep saying the cap's gonna go up. They say it enough times that it's stapled into my brain, the cap's gonna go up.
The way they talk about the cap going up, it's to the point where when a deal has term, I think it's better.
That used to be the risky thing, remember? Like, oh, it's got term, oh, I don't know. Could go south, I don't know. But then the Leafs signed David Kampf to 2.5, and I'm like, ooh, that's too much. And then they go 4 years, and I'm like, oh, okay.
That's the opposite of how it's supposed to go, but because the cap is gonna go up, that's how I feel.
But when you're not able to sign a player to term, like a lot of players are just not gonna want to sign for term if the contract that they want just isn't out there, they'll sign the 1 year deal, they'll put up a ton of points, Bertuzzi, Domi, however this goes in Toronto, they're gonna put up a lot of points, and they're gonna be able to take that into free agency, and that is appealing.
In the meantime, you're here, have a jersey, you might as well try to win the cup.
Now, Tyler Bertuzzi, that's easy. He's gonna play with one of Matthews and Tavares, and one of Marner and Nylander. He's probably gonna spend a decent chunk of the season playing with a mixture of those four guys. Max Domi? I actually don't know. He could play center. He could. Should he be for the Leafs? Should he be? David Kampf in the mix. Sam Lafferty also in the mix. Pontus Holmberg. Cali Yarncroke can play center. I don't think they want him to. The Leafs did a whole bunch of experimenting with their bottom six at the beginning of last season, and I think they may do that again this one, and I heard you go, bottom six. It might not be bottom six, but then where do you put Nyes? And these are the lovely conversations that we couldn't have had 24 hours ago when I was telling you that the Leafs forward core was going to have like Bobby McMahon and Alex Steeves. I think I had Lafferty on the third line, which no. Although Domi would know Lafferty from his time in Chicago. Lafferty had a pretty good season last year with Chicago, and so did Domi. 18 goals in 60 games with the Blackhawks, but he's a playmaker. 31 assists for 49 points in 60 games. Goes to Dallas, not so hot in the regular season. 20 games for them, just 2 goals, 7 points. In 19 playoff games for Dallas, 19 games. Dallas did really well this year. Domi had 3 goals and 10 assists for 13 points. Oh, and 60, that can't be right. Oh, no, it's 52 penalty minutes. He had 64 career penalty minutes in the playoffs, so I almost fainted. 52 in one playoff run, though. Now, hey, slow down. You're going to be like, Steve, we are going too far in the other direction. Penalty minutes are not a good thing. I know. Listen, you have to acknowledge, like I did last video, that the Leafs this season are going for a different flavor. Bertuzzi is a bunting replacement upgrade, probably. Higher upside when it comes to offense, and he might even bring more aggressiveness. Oh, I avoided saying the word violence. He's a violent player. Max Domi has both soft and rock solid hands. Soft playmaking hands and rock solid face punching hands. And if you got something to say to him, and if you got something to say to Tyler, you might have something to say to Ryan. And then all of a sudden you run out of something to say and you realize it's not worth it. Look, it comes at a cost. Kind of like John Klingberg as well. Klingberg, great offensive tools, horrible at defense. Max Domi, kind of the same, great offensive tools, horrible at defense. And this is kind of interesting because you look at the Leafs over the last couple days, they probably made themselves better offensively, worse defensively, and far more violent, and oh my god, the Leafs made themselves into the Florida Panthers. Now, should you try to model yourself after the Florida Panthers? No. Because yes, playing a certain style helped the Florida Panthers in the playoffs, but barely making the playoffs is not a game plan. Look, here's what it is to me as a Leaf fan. I bought all in. I bought in to what they were doing over the last many years, and if they just keep going, if they keep pushing, they're going to crack it. And this past year, Ryan O'Reilly, Noel Achari, it still kills me that Achari leaving to the Penguins hurts more than O'Reilly turning down Toronto's offer and going to Nashville. Luke Shen, oh, that hurts too. That hurts too. They go out and they get Jake McCabe and Lafferty in the same deal. Last year really seemed like the Leafs were the best version of themselves that they could be. A super skilled team, a defensively responsible team that can punish you, won't let themselves be punished, or so we thought, just more durable, more willing to get into the fight, more willing to take a hit. And when they beat Tampa, I thought they had opened Pandora's box and they could go all the way. And then the Florida series happened, and that was bloody anarchy, and it was not an outlier. Go and watch Vegas versus Edmonton. Go and watch Vegas versus anybody and Florida versus anybody. I complain about the calls. I complain about the rules. I complain about the Department of Player Safety. They're not gonna do anything. Operation They Can't Suspend Us All appears to be a go. And by the way, I've talked about Max Domi and Tyler Bertuzzi putting up a ton of points and then leaving in free agency. That doesn't have to happen because the cap is going up for the Leafs too. Dude, Max Domi, for his last name alone, is going to get at least 6 digits worth of endorsements in this city. Are you kidding? Now, here's where it's going to get spicy, though. How are the Leafs going to afford all this? The answer is nobody knows. From Cap Friendly, the mighty Cap Friendly, they updated Toronto's page. There's a lot of information there, but here's what you really need to know. With a roster of 12 forwards, 7D, 2 goalies, and 1 guy on IR, that's Jake Muzzin, they will have negative $8.05 million of cap space. So you might be saying to yourself, how can the Leafs have negative $8 million of cap space? Here's a fun thing. In the summer, you're actually allowed to go over the cap. You're allowed to go over the cap by 10%. The cap is 83.5. So what? $8.35 million over the cap. That's how much you're allowed to go over in the offseason. That's the only way the Leafs can go about doing this. And they still have to re-sign Ilya Samsonov. I've seen it out there, producer Drew. people talking about Aiden Hill getting $4.9 million and that maybe being a benchmark for Samsonov. I'm going to remind everyone, Aiden Hill won the cup! I think term is also going to play a huge factor. I'm not even comfortable really guessing Samsonov's number because it's going to be so wildly different just based on term. There are some things this team can do. Connor Timmins is not one of the top six defensemen for the Toronto Maple Leafs. He makes over $1 million. Sam Lafferty may not even make the opening night lineup. He makes over $1 million. Matt Murray is the big one, though. 4-point-something cap hit because Ottawa retained, but the actual money owed this season, no signing bonus, it's just pure salary, for Matt Murray is $8 million. Cash. I don't know how the Leafs get rid of that without a huge sweetener. I suppose LTIR is maybe possible, but I don't think you should assume. But hey, just like yesterday when I said it's July 1st, I looked down at my calendar. Look at that. Look at that. It's July 2nd. Hey, you're probably watching this July 3rd. Ahoy there, future. Here's the good news with the Max Domi signing and also Tyler Bertuzzi. The Toronto Maple Leafs are a better hockey team today than they were yesterday. That means Brad Treliving did a good job today. There are still wild rumors everywhere. Still hasn't re-signed Matthews. That's a big priority. Still hasn't re-signed William Nylander. Marner now has a full no move, so just, that's not even an option. There's rumors that Treliving is maybe going to pick at the carcass that is the Calgary Flames. Nikita Zadorov is a rumor there. Someone's going to have to be going out. There's so much summer left. There's so much summer left. Let's just wait and see. What do you think of the prodigal son coming home in Max Domi? God, it was weird. It's weird. Like, you're going to be at a Leaf game next year, and they're going to show Tie Domi on the Jumbotron, and everyone's going to lose their mind every time. The last time I saw Tie Domi, he was in a box at a Stars game with Mike Tyson and Ric Flair. Like, it's about to get weird. It's about to get real weird, even more weird than usual. And I can't wait. But for now, that is it for this one. Thank you very much for watching. Click like if you like this video. Click subscribe if you really liked it. And subscribe to SDPN Sports. Follow reporter Chris, for goodness sakes. Tell all your friends. Leafs got a little meaner. The Toronto meaner Leafs. We'll work on it. We'll, yeah.